traumatic brain injury is when the brain is traumatized. It can be from an external force. It can be from a bleed in the brain. But when you're talking about a traumatic brain injury, it's usually when there's a force that's applied to the head. It could be mild, it could be very, very hard. We usually classify traumatic brain injuries along a continuum, anywhere from what we consider mild traumatic brain injuries up to more severe traumatic brain injuries.
I was in a car accident. I was in Washington, D.C. I was a senior economist at an environmental think tank, and I was trying to merge into traffic by the Lincoln Memorial, so very iconic. The person who hit me from behind, and I wasn't really aware of some of the symptoms that were beginning to emerge. I knew I was having headaches, and so it was sort of a process of discovery over a fairly long period of time. The problems with adding happened in, you know, maybe the first 2 weeks, where it was clear to others that something was wrong.
Mild traumatic brain injuries often are where there's no loss of consciousness. In fact, about 90% of the time, there's not a loss of consciousness in mild traumatic brain injuries. A lot of individuals consider concussion to be the same as mild traumatic brain injuries. In fact, a lot of times the terms are used interchangeably. Usually a concussion is kind of a more milder mild traumatic brain injury if you really want to split hairs.
I've had 4 concussions in total diagnosed. The first one was in 8th grade. I was just playing basketball with my friend. We were screwing around, and I was taking a jump shot around the 3-point line, no big deal. One of my friends pushed me in the chest as I was shooting, and I kind of rolled back. I didn't like land on my back. I rolled back and my head hit the court. And from then on, I just remember I was kind of looking at the roof for about 5 minutes until someone came over and started talking to me. And the coach took me over to the nurse, and from then I went to the doctor and I was told that I had a concussion.
A concussion is a metabolic disruption. When the brain's functioning normally, what you have is chemicals on the outside of the cell and chemicals on the inside. And this is how the brain functions metabolically. But what happens in a concussion is if it's hit, the brain cells will lose their shape, and the chemicals on the outside go inside, and the chemicals on the inside are forced outside. When those get mixed up, the brain's not functioning properly.
Every brain injury is different because every person is different, and the way the symptoms manifest are going to be different in every person. So you and the people around you are the best judge of what's normal for you.
It was terrifying to have somebody greet me as if they knew me very well and not know who it was.
Any type of traumatic brain injury or head injury needs attention initially. Some of the symptoms that we see after a concussion can vary greatly, but the most common is headache. You can have headache, sensitivity to light, sensitivity to sound. You can have balance problems. You can see blurred vision. You can have double vision. They can become more emotional. They can get very angry and irritable. Confusion, fatigue are very, very common symptoms that we see after a concussion.
There were a few times, like the next time I had a concussion, that was playing football, when I was questioning whether or not I even wanted to go to a doctor about it. I knew that I had a really bad head problem after I got hit, and I continued practicing for about 45 minutes. And then I threw up, and after I threw up, I kind of realized that something was wrong. That was the end of my football career, pretty much.
When it comes to concussions, you're a student first and an athlete second. It's very important that an athlete who sustained a concussion be able to function at school prior to return to competition. No symptoms, cognitively intact, doing well at school, then return to play. It's just as important for the adults to follow the same idea of a gradual return to work. The harder they push, the more symptoms they have, the longer or more protracted their concussion is going to be.
I wanted to get back to work. I wanted to get back to my life. I wanted to get back to my athletics. And one part of your brain is saying, I used to be able to do this. And the other part of your brain is clearly not able to do it.
The typical time course for recovery from concussion often varies. It varies for ages and it varies for the individual.
It's been a long journey. My brain is still getting better. And I guess the thing to tell you is that a lot of people are told that they can't get better after 1 or 2 years from a brain injury. And I have gotten a lot better.
You're gonna get through it. Your body is going to recover. And if you are really open with like your teachers and your coaches and your friends about it, people are gonna try to help you. No one wants to see you suffer.
It's medical resiliency skills of recognizing that there are ups and downs in everybody's life. And with a brain injury, the ups can be higher sometimes, but the downs can be much lower. And I guess that's why cognitive rehab was able to help me turn my life around. Some of it is just recognizing this too shall pass, right? This too shall pass.
In the immediate future for me, I'm going to University of Denver for college. My plan is to get a 5-year MBA because they have a program for that. I'm gonna see what college basketball has in store. I really wanna see what the workload is like first year. And if I think that I can manage it, I might try second year because honestly, I'll have had like at least a year off from concussions, hopefully is the plan. If I really, really want to do it still, I think I might give it a go.
The Office of Acquired Brain Injury is a tremendous resource. We are a small office with big heart, and we make it our business to reach out and know what's going on, to find those resources that are really hard to find, and to take the time to really listen to your story and to understand and appreciate what you are going through.